Good evening. Sorry, good morning. I invite you to remain in West Africa, since I'm going to tell you about traditional uses of kola nuts by Mande peoples. And first of all, who are Mande peoples? It is a group of ethnic groups which inhabit West Africa and which speak Mande languages. It is one of the biggest family in Africa. The largest ethnic groups are the Bambara, the Dan, Maninka, Manding, Soso, etc. The total population is over 30 million people, and here you can see some representatives. Here you can see the map which illustrates the distribution of the Mande peoples. They live from Senegal up to the northern part of Cameroon. Our research focused mostly on Guinea, Mali, Côte d'Ivory Coast, and Senegal. The main sources of information is the data collected during the Russian visiting expeditions to West Africa. Now I'm going to tell you a little about these linguistic expeditions. They were found by Mr. Valentin Godrin, together with his Swiss colleague Thomas Piard. It was the first expedition in Ivory Coast in 2001, and since then this expedition became annual, and we visited Ivory Coast, Guinea, and Mali. The main sources of information are the dictionaries created by the members of our team and text corpora. These corpora contain texts collected during the fieldwork. These texts are spontaneous, and they represent some some ethnographic information about the life of these people, and some stories, some folklore stories. The important source of information is also personal communications, so I'd like to express my thanks to all the members who participated in this investigation. And I'd like to say that in this presentation we use photos from the field trips taken by the members of our team. Now I'm going to tell you about the kola genus. This genus consists of about 100-120 species. It is classified as belonging to a family Malvaceae and subfamily Struculoidae. Here you can see the distribution of this genus. What interest can be said about first of all, I'd like to tell you about the flower. It is interesting that the flower has no petals, and the things that you can see here are actually sepals. As for fruits, they are secondary apocarpus, and they consist of dehiscent follicles, as you can see here. It should be noted that what is usually called kola nuts are not nuts, actually. their seeds. They consist of lobate cotyledons. Some of the seeds look as if they have 3, 4, 5 cotyledons. This fact is very usual, very important for the use of these nuts. Kola nuts are usually red, pink, or colorless. There are two main cultivated species, Kola nitida and Kola cominata. Kola nitida as a wild plant can be found all over the West Africa, but it is mostly cultivated as a cultural plant. It can be found all over the tropical Africa, but as a wild plant it couldn't be found to the west of Ghana. Here is a Kola cominata, which has the narrower area of cultivation. Now I'm going to tell about the traditional uses of Kola. First of all, it is used as a stimulant. It is used by all Mande peoples. Kola believed to produce a tonic effect to help to overcome tiredness, depress appetite, to improve digestion, and some people believe that it can be an aphrodite. That's why kola nuts are chewed mostly by aged people after meals, in order to improve digestion. Students chew it before exams, and it is an unusual gift by a girl to her sexual partner for a sexual act. It is interesting that there is no sex age constraints in West Africa, which is opposite to the situation in Central Africa, Central African societies, where it is the consumption of kola nuts are highly ritualized and is restricted by the use of adult men. You cannot find kola nuts in the market in village. It is distributed in a secret. What can be said about use of kola in culinary code? It is opposed to staple food. Among the Bamana, there is a term nigelafen, which means literally "think of desire." Those are different things which can be desired. They include grilled meat, fried plantain, tea, coffee, and also not food like cigarettes, etc. These nigelafen are opposed to foodstuff, staple food, because usual food like manioc is consumed in family, and nigelafen are usually consumed in together with friends. So it is more individual type of consumption. What is interesting that at least in Ivory Coast, kola begins to be consumed in a new form, like an extract, which is used to produce energy drinks, Here you can see this cola force, a new alcoholic energy drink produced in Ivory Coast. Other practical uses of cola include its use as a coloring substance. The traditional use of color of cola nuts include its use as a textile dye, which is used to manufacture so-called tissue for rice and rye, which means a cloth of I don't know how to translate for a sacre. Well, it is a place where the initialization which is is carried out. It is interesting that there are two different types of dyeing this cloth, and cola nuts is used only in one of them, which is carried by the Loma and Kupeli people who live near the town of Zarakara in Kiev. And the second type of use as a coloring substance is its use for drawing symbols on the face. This type of use is practiced by mothers among men. It is believed to protect children from evil spirits. Cola is a symbol of hospitality. It is an unusual gift for the host or for the elder relatives. Cola is used as a wedding rite. It serves as a symbolic medium between the grooms and the bride's lineages. When someone wants to marry here, he just some cola nuts to the bride's family, and if the answer is yes, he receives two or four white cola nuts, but which are more evaluated. But if the answer is no, he will receive red cola nuts. Cola is used in some animist practices like divination, future telling. If you have some problem, you just go to fetisher and he will ask yes/no question and throw cola nuts. And the answer of ancestors' spirits is explained by the position of the cola nuts on the floor. This is practiced by many Mande peoples, Pamana, Mandin, Kupeli, Muroma, Muanga. It is interesting that the form of cola nuts is important too. One of the most important form of cola nuts is so-called three cotyledons nuts. You remember that the cotyledons of cola nuts can be splitted, so some of them look like if they have three cotyledons. These nuts believed to be a source of superpower, and you can't consume it on your own. You have to share it with your friend. A knot resembling a horse head is used for some specific sacrifices. A knot resembling a stone of a character fruit symbolizes prosperity and steadfastness. A knot with overlapping cotyledons used to seduce a sexual partner. It is also important that the first knot taken from the basket without any bargain and without any choosing promises the triumph, and while the last knot in the basket means a reward for the efforts or a quick realization of the plans. Interesting enough that despite of its wide use in animistic practices, colonnades have been adopted by Islamic culture, and it is an usual gift for imam in the mosque in Europe. Well, thank you for your attention.